the same you or all the same me, we wouldn't have any of these other YouTubers to be. I'm a poet and I don't even know it. Let's go. What's going on YouTube? It's Jay Wilson, JayWill07, Instagram, Twitter, Jason Wilson on Facebook, NorthfinUSA.com. So here today, we're going to be talking about why my tank doesn't look like that and why I'm not satisfied with my tank. And the reason I bring this up is because as we've set up the 500 gallon, all of these fish are mine. The design is mine. However, the tank, yes, is not mine. So there's been a little chatter throughout that, you know, this tank is not mine, and I'll be the first one to tell you it's not, because my tank will be custom built. And I'm custom building it myself. I'm picking the length, the height, the style of glass. I'm making sure everything is right. So for the time being, while I'm at work at the showroom, I wanted to have something where I can view my predators. And what better way than to commandeer a tank that wasn't being used properly? But as we set it up, there's been a lot of things I've done differently, and let me show you. We've got the tree branch here. I've got some larger rocks, some real rocks in here. I've got the larger TS-008, which is from Universal Rocks. And of course, all of this is gonna be from Universal Rocks. It's not a sales pitch. It's what I've always liked. It's what I've liked before I've worked here. But as you can see, it's kind of a gravel sand-esque style thing with a Malawi rock background. And what I've done is I've tried to recreate some sort of lake-like look. And by doing that, I want it to get to this kind of monotone browns, some lighter sand, and brightly colored fish as they grow, which will happen. But I've got a lot of questions. Why is the tank water so cloudy? Why isn't it Jay Wilson clear? And I understand that I've come to be known as the person that has a clear tank. And while I greatly appreciate it, there's something different about this tank. It's much bigger in terms of volume. I'm doing something completely different. And as you can see, it is clearing up. Now on video, you probably see a slight haze at the top. That is going away dramatically. I've done two water changes on this tank, one yesterday, did some filter maintenance, and it is getting much clearer. But I wanted to talk to you about why you're not satisfied with your tank. Why? I'm satisfied with mine. Of course, I always want it to be better, but only because I want to view it differently, not because it's a competition. It should never, ever be a competition in the hobby unless you're participating in some sort of aquascape competition or you're showcasing your fish at an American Cichlid Association convention or the aquatic experience where you're bringing your fish there to showcase. But this should never be a competition between YouTubers or hobbyists, Facebook friends. That's just downright silly and ultimately childish. What it should be about is what you enjoy looking at and getting inspiration from others. So while I watch a few YouTubers, you know, I'm watching Adam C, I'm watching Fish Nerd Blogs, I watch Peck Tech, I watch Miss Jinx, just to name a few. And while these folks give me inspiration to what I'm doing, when it comes down to it, the implementation is all mine. It has to be all yours. So folks, don't view this as a competition. View it as inspiration. When you watch somebody and they tell you something, it doesn't have to be black and white. There can be a ton of gray area and allow you to implement it the way you'd like to. Just because I used wood in my tank doesn't mean you have to use wood. But if you like it, by all means, please do it. Folks, I'm happy with the tank. I hope you're happy in what you're doing, because sometimes the fish hobby can get convoluted, and all you have to do is look through the BS, enjoy what you enjoy, do what you do, and ultimately you will have fun. But if you allow influence from others, or you allow things to happen from other people for you, you will then in turn turn into that same person, and well, then there becomes no diversity in what we do. And what makes this hobby so thrilling is the diversity within all of the aspects there is to be had. Folks, the American Cichlid Association is going to be having their annual amazing event. It's in Houston. I expect to see you there. And well, leave a comment. What do you like about the tank? What do you want to see differently? I can't grow the fish much faster. I'm feeding them Krill Pro every other day, and all of the fish seem to be doing really well. Next video, you're going to see something that I've never done before, and I wouldn't have the abilities in my home to do, but I have the abilities here. And so with my own money and some aquascaping techniques that were inspired by channels like Miss Jinx, DIY Aqua Pros, and those folks, Aquarium Co-op, I was able to do what I just did in the tank right behind you. You'll see that next video. And I want to give a special shout out to Odie. Odie has become a huge supporter. He is very excited every time I talk to him on the phone. And instead of saying holla, he likes to say hello. So Odie, you know what's next. Hello.
Thanks everybody for just viewing my channel. If you could just hit subscribe and say the three magic words, Mishka, Mushka, Mickey Mouse.
Or you can just subscribe because I just did a stupid Mickey voice.